Ang 2018 UEFA Champions League Final sa pagitan ng Liverpool at Real Madrid sa Kiev. Gaganapin ang laban ngayong May 27, Manila time, that's 2 a.m. by the way, at masasaksihan dito ang harapan ng dalawang football greats na sina Cristiano Ronaldo at Mo Salah. Let's talk now to football analysts Marielle Benitez and Mikey Carreon. Good evening, boys and girls. Welcome back to the Score. Good to have you with us.
Good evening, TJ.
All right, let's break this down. First of all, i-explain natin sa mga fans natin, sa mga viewers natin, lalo sa mga hindi ganun ka-familiar sa football scene, kung bakit napakalaking tournament itong UEFA Champions League. Marielle, for you, why is it such a big league that everybody who loves football really has to appreciate what they see when they see the Champions League?
Well, of course, in the Champions League, you have the best teams in Europe. So there are 32 teams in the qualifying round where they have they play home and away up until they reach the finals. And these are the best or the top four teams in each country that play here in the Champions League.
Okay, good. And Mikey, I understand that this Champions League goes on at the same time that their domestic leagues are still ongoing, the EPL or La Liga, diba? How is that? How tricky is that for these club teams to balance their efforts, their schedule? And would you say that some clubs will give less effort in either in their local league or in the Champions League, or each game they play, whether it's the EPL or La Liga or the Champions League, bigay todo sila?
Well, I think, TJ, especially if you look at the big teams, they are, like you said, they have to go all out in both competitions.
Both, okay.
You know, the big teams, they want to win the league. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a long season.
Yeah.
You know, so that's where they're tested, you know, how strong they are in a regular basis.
Yep.
And then you got the Champions League where you're going up, like Mariel just said, you have the best teams in the continent. So these big clubs, they want to win both competitions. So they basically go all out. And and I think it's not a problem for them. They're very well prepared to play Wednesdays and on the weekends as well. And like Mariel was saying, the Champions League, it's the biggest club competition.
Saka, yeah. would you say mas exciting ang format niya? Kasi may championship eh.
Uh-oh.
As compared to like the EPL, di ba? You just play the round robin, the team with the most points, in the end, is the champion. Sometimes, anticlimactic na they win it enough points, even though they have one or two more games to go. So, the format itself, does it make it more appealing, Maria, for you?
Yeah, I mean, yes, it makes it more exciting. Like what you said, in the league, when you get all your points, sometimes you have 3-4 games to go and you're leading by like 17 points.
Correct.
So, no chance for the other team. So,
correct.
Even the last few games you play, parang no bearing for you.
Yeah.
While here in the Champions League, you play home and away, and as you move up to through the stages, to the finals,
knockout
then you
stuff.
Get knockout.
Correct.
These are teams and players who are very very good in football, very popular, and have a huge fan base. So it is very exciting.
Okay, pag-usapan natin yung dalawang natitira, the last two teams standing. And it's no surprise who you're rooting for, my friend, with the jersey you're wearing today. But I'll let you, you know, have a go at this first. Madrid is looking for another title. What makes them the favorite? Why are they so favorite for this one?
Well, first of all, I think, TJ, they're the favorites because if you just look at the past, they won it back-to-back.
Mm-hmm.
The last 2 years, Real Madrid's won the Champions League.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at the last 4 years, they've won it 3 times.
Okay.
And they're in the finals again this year.
Mm-hmm.
So I think just for that reason alone, they are the favorites. And if you look at the history of the Champions League, Real Madrid has actually 12 trophies already.
Wow. Okay.
You know, so they are, whenever they step into this competition, I think Madrid, you know, it's not about being cocky or disrespecting your opponent, but just from the history of the Champions League and the number of trophies they have, I think whenever they step into this competition, whoever they play against, you can say they are the favorites.
Mm-hmm.
And Real Madrid, every single team in Europe, they know that Real Madrid, if they can be having a bad season in the league. Like this year, they were like 15 points behind, and it's happened in the past.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to the Champions League, TJ, parang may switch sila that, you know, their game just changes and it's a team very difficult to beat in the Champions League.
Marielle, introduce us to, you know, some of the big names in this team. Why are they so good? As Mikey has given us the brief history of what they've been able to achieve in the last few years, nandiyan na si Ronaldo. Gaano kagaling talaga itong Real Madrid?
I mean, you have pretty much the superstars in this team. You have players from the bench who could actually be starters
ganun
as well.
Wow.
Yes,
okay.
So you say you have Toni Kroos, and these are the guys that who are leading their teams in the World Cup.
Mm-hmm.
You have Gareth Bale, mga superstars, Marcelo and all the Sergio Ramos.
Mm-hmm.
So talagang it's a team that is experienced playing in the Champions League. Mm-hmm. They're probably, I think a few of them are playing on their fourth Champions League final. Wow, okay. So talagang the experience is there with Real Madrid.
For Liverpool naman, for most people, they understand it's a bit of a surprise. But how did they get to this point, and who can they lean on, and what are the chances? What do you think?
Liverpool? I think with Liverpool, they've been playing very well. You have someone like Mo Salah, mm-hmm. who has been really a star for Liverpool. He's been scoring goals for them, and they say they have like one of the best trios with Firmino and Mane. Mm-hmm. And I think compared to Real Madrid, they've had a very good season for them in their domestic league, mm-hmm. winning it. And they showed like throughout the stages that they were also dominating or playing well as compared to Real Madrid, that they had to go through tough matches and were also lucky coming into the finals.
For you, Mikey, why do you feel still that they are a formidable foe? I mean, as much as Real Madrid is favored, how good is Liverpool, and who does Real Madrid have to be watching out for, and how they play?
Basically, Marielle just said it, TJ. Mm-hmm. It's those three guys up
those
front.
Those three guys, yeah.
Mane, Salah, and Firmino, mm-hmm. the Brazilian. If you look at their season in the Champions League, they scored 29 goals between mm-hmm. the three of them. And that's the record in the history of the Champions League.
Okay.
I think the record, they beat the record of Real Madrid mm-hmm. By the BBC, Bale, mm-hmm. Benzema, and Cristiano, who had 28 goals.
Okay.
So these three players, Mane, Salah, and Firmino, they scored 29 this season.
Mm-hmm.
So, they're really a threat up front.
Yep.
Very dangerous, mm-hmm. those three. And I think you also got to give credit their coach.
Okay.
Jurgen Klopp, the German coach of Liverpool.
Okay.
He's a very tactical, very tactical coach. The style of football he likes playing, a lot of journalists in Europe, they're saying it's rock and roll football.
Mm-hmm.
The type of football he likes mm-hmm. playing. So I think he's been a big part of the success in Liverpool. But never forget those three players up front.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, some are even saying that some may even consider the Champions League even at a higher level than even the World Cup. I don't know if you want to go that far, but how can you look and compare? Because, like, for example, you format the World Cup after the group stages, knockout yan, although one game lang yan.
Yes.
Ito at least, kahit pa paano, merong one leg sa bahay mo, one leg sa bahay nila. For some, that might be more appealing. But when you compare this to the World Cup in terms of how hype the Champions League is, what is it for you, Maria?
I mean, I think with the Champions League, it's because you have the top players mm-hmm. playing with the top club teams.
Yeah.
As compared to maybe the World Cup, yes, it's a lot of pride to represent your country.
Right.
But like they say, like Messi, he's mm-hmm. like one or a few superstars playing for their country.
Right.
So here you really get to see the talent, the skills,
mm-hmm.
and it makes it very exciting. And parang, syempre, if you win it, talagang there's a lot of pride, mm-hmm. not just for the players, but for the club team as well.
For you, Mikey, how big do you see the Champions League when you look and compare it to the World Cup?
Well, the Champions League, like we've been talking about, TJ, it's huge. It's mm-hmm. a huge competition. But I think at the level of the World Cup, maybe not yet.
Mm-hmm.
No, but the Champions League, it's a very prestigious tournament. I just want to go back to your initial question. You were asking about the format.
Yep.
The format changed in 1992.
1992.
Before 1992, only the champions mm-hmm. of each country would play. So only one team per country,
uh-huh.
and it was knockout stage right away.
Right away.
So you could have the two best teams in the competition face each other in the first round already.
Wow, okay.
So it started back in 1955. Wow. So I think that's what makes it so prestigious, because, like I said, you only had one team from each country, the best of each country.
During the time,
so to win it back then, it was a big thing.
Champions League.
Yes, exactly.
Oh,
it really was Champions League.
Yes.
But now, you got some countries where you got three or four teams coming in.
Mm-hmm.
But nonetheless, I think if you get the top clubs, like you say, Real Madrid, the Barcelonas, mm-hmm. the
Bayern
Liverpool, Bayern Munich, if you make them, I think if you make them play the World Cup, they'd have a big chance of winning the World Cup going up against these countries. Because if you look at the World Cup in TJ, you have 5 to 10 teams that are strong.
Yeah.
But then after that 10th team, mm-hmm. There's a lot of teams, you got to say maybe the Asian, they're not as strong.
Right.
But if you look at the Champions League, like I said, you got three really tough teams, four tough teams from each country mm-hmm. in Europe. So those are a lot of really strong clubs competing against each other.
What's the vibe like here? Like, I know this weekend, you know, a lot of, you know, fans, you guys will have your chosen hangouts right to watch it. For you, Marielle, what's it like for you to watch a Champions League, not another final? And what's it like? What's the atmosphere like?
I mean, I think just like Mikey, I'm a Real Madrid fan. Mm-hmm. So I'm excited that they're in the finals once again. Mm-hmm. And you hear a lot of people trying to get together, have viewing parties, mm-hmm. either at the bar or in someone's home. So I think it's good. It's a prequel maybe to the World Cup, mm-hmm. staying up late at night
at
watching
the
games.
For the vibe, no?
Yes, yeah, so I think it's exciting. So it's a stepping stone to staying up late and preparing the Philippines or the viewers for the World Cup.
Well, if this is any indication how one of them is a huge fan, tell us a bit about this, my friend. How many years have you, you know, collected all these?
Well, yes, these are most of my... all my jerseys, TJs.
Good thing your wife said to keep all of these in the closet.
Well, my wife, Nikki, yes, she has no choice. But she's also given me a lot of some jerseys.
Nice, so
TJ,
okay.
She supports me 100% in this. So like I said, I got the jerseys here. I got some scarves. Mm-hmm. You can see some flags,
yep.
Some shirts from, I'm a member of the Peña Madridista in New York.
And I'm sure you've watched them live.
Yes.
What was it like, your first time to watch them live?
First time to watch them live was back in 1986.
Wow!
So this was the first thing I ever bought in the Bernabeu.
Okay.
My grandfather brought me.
Oh, wow.
Actually, it was my grandfather and my dad who really got me into being a Real Madrid supporter, not TJ. So the first time, I guess, I was 11, 12 years old. Uh-huh. So I didn't really, you know, I was really happy to be there, of course, but. Later on, when I was, you know, older and you got a better sense of everything, it's really hard to explain.
Uh-huh.
I mean, Marielle, I think she's been there. But for me, it's really hard to explain being in the Bernabeu. It's full. When the players come out, it's hard to explain. I'm sure even it's really difficult.
Yeah.
It's difficult to explain.
I'm
getting goosebumps now.
Exactly.
He's talking about it. His hair is rising.
Because
it's the most of our sports, our live sports, hati yung crowd.
Yes.
May Ateneo, may Lasal, may, you know, team B, whatever. It's rare that we experience home and away. It's now that ASCAS have more home games, we can feel it. And then as well with Gilas, they've had this new format in FIBA. We're starting to feel it. But what was it like for you, Mel, when you first experienced that vibe of a home team? You know,
well,
really supporting the team. And
the first time I was able to watch was 2007.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next time, or the most recent one, was last November. And it was the same feeling. You come into the Bernabeu, the lights are bright. It was a UEFA Champions League as well. And literally goosebumps. And, you know, you feel everyone screaming each player's mm-hmm. name when they get introduced. And everyone's just pretty much on their feet. And then you see, like, a small side where the away crowd is watching.
On top, far away.
So talagang, it's just really yung energy ng lahat. I mean, you really feel it.
Galing. Oh, lastly, Fearless forecast.
For me?
Yeah.
My result is going to be 3-1 TJ. Why?
Uh-huh.
Because it's the opposite of 13.
Okay.
If Real Madrid wins, it's going to be their 13th trophy.
Okay.
So I'm going for a 3-1 hat trick by Cristiano Ronaldo.
Okay, and for you, Maria?
I'd say 3-2.
Okay.
I think
3-2.
They would Madrid to win, but I think the trio that we were saying of Liverpool would also be trying to get their chances.
We'll get there on the board.
Yes.
Well, we all can't wait all the more. Thanks for... Yes, senor. Last
yes, week. And lastly, I just want to send a shout out to Philippine Madridistas.
Oh, yes.
Who are watching us here.
Uh-huh.
And of course, my wife and daughters always watch the road to Russia as well. So.
Salamat. Thanks, guys. We'll be all enjoying this game wherever you are, whatever sports bar you're at, or at home watching it here in SNA. It's live Sunday morning at 2:30 in the morning,
yes.
Right? So thanks, Marielle, Mikey. Great to have you guys here.
Hey everybody, this is Anton Rojas. For more sports updates, keep watching The Score and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. That's ABS-CBN Sports and Action.